Before 1992, before I ever touched a computer, I played a lot of games on the NES. And on the NES, one of the most fascinating things to me were the password generators. I am Bisqwit, and in this series we explore how old games generate their passwords.
Downtown Naked Monogatari, or by its English name River City Ransom, is a fighting game known for many things. One of these things is its absurdly long passwords. The passwords seem to be made of 63 different symbols. But 63 is such an unsatisfying number. We need one more to make it a power of 2. It should be 64, right? Ah well, there's one. The space. I forgot to count the space. Now the number of symbols is 64. All good, except for one thing. It's all wrong. Notice how there's an apostrophe on top of a B. The apostrophe is not a standalone character at all. In fact, if you try to place a standalone apostrophe, Ryan will place his fist in his mouth, and we all know that is not good. How this actually works is that you can place an apostrophe on any character. Why did they make this kind of system in a game aimed for USA people, who don't use accented characters at all? We will get back to this later. So instead of space, we have 62 accented characters for a total of 124 symbols. And I guess the space is there too. This is still not a power of 2. Where are the remaining 3 to make a full power of 2, 128? The answer is nowhere. In fact, even some of these are invalid. The total number of permissible symbols is 114. These symbols map straight to numbers because computer programs really deal with numbers, not letters. However, if you make some experiments, you will notice that the only accented symbols the game ever generates is A or B. It generates the only first 64 symbols. Thank goodness, because the accented characters are so much work to enter in this game. It is therefore a reasonable conclusion that each letter stores 6 bits of meaningful data. Now let's study the password structure. All of this information comes from the disassembly of the game I did yesterday. In fact, I have never played this game. I chose this game because someone like you recommended it to me after watching previous episodes of this show. So the passwords are 33 letters long. From now on, I will call these letters as cells, because each cell stores something in particular. The last cell stores the encryption key. Using this key and a secret cipher that is hidden inside the game ROM, the game encrypts and decrypts passwords with an algorithm that is identical both ways. After the password has been decrypted, we gain access to more cells. The second to last cell stores a checksum. It is the 6-bit sum of all the cells before it. If this checksum does not match, the password is rejected. The game also verifies that after decrypting, each cell must contain a value that is smaller than 64. In other words, it must be 6-bit. It is possible for there to be larger values. Now that all the decrypting and validation is out of the way, we gain access to the big picture. Here you can see what each cell is made of. We will study this in detail in a moment, but first, there's one more important thing to observe. The ranges of values that can be stored in these cells. Many of these cells store values that can be greater than 63, and the game just verified a moment ago that the value in each cell is smaller than 64. How is that possible? As we discussed earlier, each cell is a 6-bit storage. The game simulates larger cells, actually they are 8-bit, by borrowing the extra bits from another cell. This scheme is used for 6 triplets of cells. In each case, a third cell stores the extra bits for the two others. Money is a special thing in that one cell lends the extra bits for 3 different cells. So we get this map of data, where each cell is accounted for. First we have the abilities. These are the 10 stats you can see on the status screen when you pause the game. The last two stats are simulated bytes, so they have 8-bit range of values, but the game will reject the password if the value is greater than 127. But here's the killer. There are actually 11 ability scores. Let me illustrate how this works. I apologize in advance if this is actually something that everyone knows. I have never played this game before, and all I see is that the game doesn't tell the player that this ability exists. In this recording, I started the game from power on, threw some kicks and punches to show how it normally works. Then I entered the password screen and made a minimal modification to the password to change the combo stat from 0 to 63. As you can see, it had a rather dramatic effect in Alex's fighting prowess. Again, maybe you guys already knew this, but I just thought it's worth mentioning. Next, the money. It is a 5-digit number stored in BCD format, as discussed earlier. The game does a couple of checks to make sure the numbers are in valid range, but these checks are a bit half-hearted. This is why it is possible to have 560 B dollars and 70 F cents of money. Next we have two 8-bit masks. I know which RAM addresses the game reads and writes these bit masks from, but having not played this game, I don't know what it uses them for. I can only guess. My guess is there is the list of bosses that have been beaten and the list of learned special techniques. The player can have up to 8 items in their inventory, and this list is saved in the password. Each slot in the inventory is 8-bit, but because the item numbers are always multiplied by 2 to make up an offset for a pointer table, the game only cares about the first 7 bits. The most significant bit is ignored, except when checking whether the slot is blank. To dig up the list of names of these items, I created this little C++ program. Yes, I am aware that the code is not exactly standards compliant and that there's even a bug in it. In any case, it correctly prints this list of item names. And the list has such lovely items like coffee, tea, nothing, and no thanks. Let's experiment a little. I have no idea how Alex is carrying a sauna in his pocket, but evidently he's happy with it. Next we check out no thanks. Apparently, donning no thanks also consumes nothing, so we no longer have nothing. But we can throw it away though. Then let's see what is in the main menu. So yeah, this goes on for a while. In fact, I think it goes on forever. At least I haven't seen it stop. Validate your input. Now let's backtrack for a little. Remember this screen at minute 47 seconds into the video when I said, "In fact, even some of these are invalid." Turns out that the space is actually not an invalid password character. There is exactly one password where the space is actually a valid character. The password is Machine Technos Japan. As far as I know, this has never been discovered before. Google found 0 web pages that contain this exact sequence of words. The game contains a special exception for this jackpot password. It gives you the following things. Maximum values in all stats, including the hidden combo stat. It also changes the player name into Shin. In the inventory it puts all the technique books. This is necessary because the password does not set any of the bits in the bitmask fields addressed earlier. If you want the special techniques, you will have to read the book. It will also give the player maximum money. Now there is something very peculiar about that password. Something that will only make fully sense when we take a look at the Japanese version of the game, Downtown Nekketsu Monogatari. When we enter the password screen, we can immediately make a couple of interesting observations. The first is that unlike in the Western versions, in the Japanese version all passwords are actually possible to pronounce. This one, for example, is yayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayayay pattern of 5 syllables, then 7 syllables, and then 5 syllables again. This is haiku! Here's an example!
古池屋、かわず飛び込む水の音。
The password is shorter because the Japanese version uses 7-bit passwords, not 6-bit. Also, the Japanese version does not save the max power stat, the inventory contents, or the 2-bit masks. Thirdly, there are repeating patterns in the blank passwords. This suggests that the encryption is a lot simpler in the Japanese version than it is in the USA version. This is kinda true and kinda not. I found the assembler code that does the encoding in the Japanese version somewhat difficult to understand. Fourth, remember the Mshin password. It was 5 letters, then 7 letters, then 5 again. I guess it was created before the passwords were expanded into 33 letters. A window into an earlier phase of development, I guess. Oh, and the reason why so many Japanese originating English games have these funny apostrophes and stuff. That's because of Japanese, of course. In Japanese, most syllables can take a dakuten or a handakuten diacritic that modifies how the syllable is voiced. This password, for example, reads as ha 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 ba 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 ba. Now, once again, I created a program to encode and decode passwords of this game. It ended up being a little long, so I am not embedding it in the video this time. You can download it through the link that is in the video description. The video description also contains links to my homepage and to my Patreon page. It is thanks to people like Mengda Yang that I have been able to put these videos up lately. Consider becoming my patron to show your support. I am Bisqwit. The next time we may be getting another lesson in apostrophes.